be careful on one thing, that nafs, base desires, and shaitan, they are now free. They've been released. They have very unique tricks, and they're very cunning, especially the nafs. And when a person, after he makes a big effort, when he comes out, then his nafs makes him lazy, negligent. Oh, you've achieved a lot, you're fine now. Just have a bit of patience, slow down. Take it easy, need to chill out, need to rest a little bit, you've worked hard. So the nafs, the base desires, he speaks within us and influences us and directs us in this way, but it should never be this way. Rather, after reward, the method is that after attaining the reward, a person works harder. Hard after seeing the path. First and foremost, the nafs, what he'll make us laid back in, the which is the greatest ibadah, about which Allah's Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stated that on the Day of Judgment, first of all, the question will be asked about salah, our namaz. If our namaz, our salah, if that is complete, if that results positively, then all of the other deeds, the reckoning of the other deeds will be easy. And our reckoning and accounting will be easier. It's not a small minor punishment. Yes, it's a proper punishment. The thief, and if the worst of thieves, the most cunning of thieves, you'll get the worst punishment. The Prophet ﷺ said, shall I tell you who is the worst thief? The biggest thief? Who are those people who have the worst punishment? They are those people who they try to detach themselves from salah. Allahu Akbar, inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi rajun. The Sahaba Ikram, they were amazed. And as Hassan of them said, salah, they steal salah. They steal salah, Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How can you steal salah? How can the theft be committed with salah? And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the thief with regards to salah is the person ruku and sujood, the prostration and the bowing, he doesn't complete that properly. Quickly in a rush, bopping up and down, quickly I want to complete this. No, in ruku, do they complete the tasbihat? These are such postures, ruku and sujood Allah Ta'ala. He allows the du'as to be asked, supplicated in ruku, sujood, ask du'as, supplicate, make du'a. You can ask what you want in ruku and sujood. Such a blessed posture that Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala says that these are great postures in which you are remembering me, I accept the du'as. And we become thieves at that time. And we escape. This is what the Prophet is saying, that these are those people, an salatihim sahun, that with presence of heart, depth of heart, a person should praise salam. Yes, the best knowledge, the best zuhud, the best taqwa, the best solitude, the best worshipper. If you want to see somebody, he's a great alim, scholar, muhaddith, he's pious, he's zuhud, he's a muttaqi, he's memorized or he reads lots of hadith, then the basis of understanding that is what? If you want to prove that he's the best in all these things, observe the salah of that person. Observe the salah. Those people who don't care about salah, congregation, don't know about fajr, then where's their taqwa gone, zuhud gone, where's their ilm gone, where's their knowledge, where's their shaykhul hadithiyat of that person? What? Who's that person deceiving? Allah Ta'ala, He said that I've given you one basis of success, which is salah, prostration, the best muhaddith, hadith scholar, the best alim, the best zahid, the best muttaqi, the best shaykh, the best dhakir, is that individual whose salah is the best. The person who's the thief with regards to his own salah,